For the first few weeks, months, or even years of a new relationship, things can be effortlessly wonderful. But sooner or later, real life kicks in and the relationship is tested. It's from here on that although a relationship still has the potential to keep getting better, it does require some effort to make it happen. You need to work on your relationship.
Hello there. I'm going to be sharing with you the rules of relationships from the book The Rules of Love by Richard Templar. Kindly subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and please like this video. Thank you very much. Now let's get into this video.
Rule 1. Accept the differences. Embrace what you have in common. Hardly will you see two people who are exactly the same. Sometimes you see someone and you are wondering why certain things interest them. And so you have a partner who has interests that it's opposite yours. Possibly the person likes to cook and likes to try new things and new ways of cooking. And for you, the only thing you want to do is actually to eat. And that is because you are different. Different perspectives, different ideas, different priorities, different personalities, different interests. I mean, different everything. And so the author says that if you are going to have a successful relationship that lasts and makes both of you happy, then you need to get over the fact that you are both different. You have different interests, and so you cannot always agree on certain things, but you can take advantage of these differences and actually make it better. And so possibly the person's area of strength is your weaknesses and your strength is the person's weaknesses. So when you come together and put your differences together and put your strength together, then you become a union that is unstoppable.
Rule 2. Be the first to say sorry. The fact that we are created differently means we always have differences. And so the author says that it takes two to argue. And if you have a partner and there come differences and you have an argument, from the title of this point, it says that be the first to say sorry. It's not just about even saying sorry. Ensure you are the one to actually say the sorry. You are the one to say sorry first before. Sometimes you might still think that you are right and you have a valid point, but you should notice that it's not exactly the person you are fighting, and probably you are arguing over an issue. So you put the issue aside and apologize to the person.
Rule 3. You make a choice every day. The author says that for every single day you are choosing to be in a relationship with this person. If things are wrong, you are choosing either to fix them or not to fix them. He says it's your choice to get involved with this person despite their flaws and misgivings and shortcomings. Likewise, you also having the same flaws and misgivings and shortcomings. But it's your decision to want to be with this person, so don't complain when things are wrong. You are deciding either to be there or work on it or decide to leave. But know that you are where you are because you chose to be there.
Rule 4. Keep talking.
He says if you don't talk to each other, how will you know what each person is thinking or feeling? It's a relationship, so you have to continually keep talking, or you have to continually keep communicating. That way you will know when there's a problem somewhere. You will know when the person is not happy or the person is happy.
Rule 5. Don't belittle your partner.
He says there are people who usually belittle their partners. So they are in a group of company with other people and they find a way to always just bring their partner down, say words that are not nice and all kind of things. And so this rule says that do not belittle your partner. At least have respect for the person. Even if they have done something wrong to you, do not wash their dirty underwear in public. You should wait when you are alone or private or somewhere that you can tell them that probably what they did is wrong, but you don't belittle your partner by trying to disgrace them in front of people or in the midst of others.
Rule 6. Never stop trying to be attractive.
Here he says attractiveness goes beyond physical appearance, physical appearance goes beyond the clothing and everything, but it includes behavior, the way you talk to them, the way you behave with them, the way you lower your voice when you speak to them and all those things. And he says it's not just a one-sided thing. It doesn't mean the woman should be attractive only. The man is supposed to also be attractive. So don't stop being attractive because you are now with this person.
Rule 7. If you can say anything nice, do.
This is similar to the previous point.
And it also goes beyond physical, but let's say if you see your partner dressed nicely, you can tell them, oh, today you're looking beautiful. Oh, you are doing this nice. So it goes beyond, physical appearance, where the person cooks, oh, today your food is nice, it's delicious, and you, all those kind of things. So if you can say anything nice, please, we don't wait to be asked. Sometimes he says that before everything, you were giving compliments and all those things, and the person got used to the compliments, and all of a sudden you have now stopped. Why? So always ensure to say something nice to your partner, and it's a two-way street. It shouldn't be just one-sided. Rule 8, don't be a nag. He says nagging is pointless, and that research shows that if you nag somebody to do it, they're less likely to actually do it. And so if somebody doesn't want to do it, the fact that you nag them doesn't mean they would do it. And sometimes nagging usually results to resentment in the relationship, and it deteriorates the relationship. And so if your partner isn't really lazy, and you are asking them to do something and they're actually not doing it, he's saying that there's probably a reason why they are not doing it, and you should find out what the reason is rather than nagging about it. Rule 9, if little things annoy you, say so with humor. This still boils down to the fact that we are different, and no matter how much you like a person, probably there are just certain things they do that is a bit annoying, right? And you want to say it. So he's saying that if they do certain things that are annoying, try to tell them, but with humor. So find a joke in between it to just tell them. There are certain things, probably the person usually just bang a door and it's annoying to you, but the person doesn't even notice that this is how they close a door, or just certain things. Even, so many other small things they can be doing. But here he's saying that be aware that if you are telling people their little mistakes, you should be also willing to receive it when they say it. It's not everyone who really likes criticism. So if you want to criticize others, be ready to also receive it when they decide to start pointing out your little mistakes. Rule 10, know when to listen and when to act. So, there are people who usually, let's say they are angry at something or something, and they want somebody to rant to just say it. Probably they don't really want you to say anything, they just want you to listen. So this point is saying know when to listen and know when to act. So if at a point they just want you to listen to what they are saying, they want you to understand where you are coming from, the auntie to be saying, is that what happened? I really feel your pain, those kind of things. That's what the person is expecting, not necessarily going to fight for them or something. So know when to listen and when to act. And I have a bonus rule for you. Rule 11, men like flowers too. So he says that universally, it is probably accepted that women like flowers and chocolates and cakes and all of those things. But he said men like flowers too. And so it shouldn't always be all the time as a woman you are waiting to receive flowers and chocolates and all of that. What is wrong with reversing this tradition? We usually say that it's the thought that counts, right? So men enjoy flowers too. Men like chocolates too. So give your man flowers and chocolates. See part 1 of this video where I made the rules for finding love. Kindly subscribe to the channel, share this video with your friends, like this video too, and then I'll see you in the next one. Stay safe and bye.